Welcome to Channel 18 once again. And this morning, our first guest is Jim Stamboni. And Jim is going to talk with us about the concert that is going to be played here on the 21st of this month. That's right, Jim?
Good morning. Good morning, Paul.
Good
morning. Sir.
How good are to see you.
Same here. Same here.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah, we're very excited about this. This is a new band that started up last January. And the rationale for the band was that a lot of us that play in the various town bands over the summer kind of go into hiatus between December and March.
So you'd have something to do, right?
Something to do. So a lot of us that are year-rounders that don't fly south for the winter decided to try to do something. And we actually were able to get people from the various local town bands, Harwich, Chatham, Barnstable, and then we tried to decide what kind of music we wanted to play.
Okay, and that's important.
And it's kind of interesting because, you know, most of us that play with the band are of the senior citizen ilk. And although we play some of the old swing band music with the town bands, we don't really focus on it. You know, there's a broad spectrum of music. So what we decided to do is let's try to feature swing band music. And we felt that that would appeal not only to the players in the band, but also to audiences that we'd have attend. So we decided to feature that kind of music. And we talk about, you know, music of the Dorsey Brothers. We talk about Glenn Miller. We talk about Harry James, Benny Goodman, musicians and band leaders that I think we can all relate to and some of us really, really enjoy. One of the things that we tried to do is to make this band kind of an open forum, so anybody can join us on a Wednesday night. We rehearse on Wednesday nights right here at the community center for 7 o'clock, and try to not only interest the seniors but even younger folks who maybe are not being exposed to this kind of music. So it's an open forum, and we're having quite a lot of fun with it. Of course, usually the payoff for a musician is the opportunity to perform in front of people.
Yes, of course.
And so the opportunity that we have coming up on October 21st, right here at the Community Center, is a 1.5 hour concert featuring the kind of music that we just talked about. And we're hoping that to start something new here on the Mid-Cape. There are some big bands on the Cape, only a couple, but they're not in the Mid-Cape area. So this also, I think, is good for people in our general area that want to come and enjoy this kind of music. And hopefully we will attract not only us seniors, but also younger people that say, what's this music all about, you know?
That's right.
Some of the music that we're going to be playing, I mentioned the composers and the performers, but in terms of things you might resonate with relative to the particular songs, songs like The Jersey Bounce, American Patrol, which was a big hit by Glenn Miller. We're doing a Goodman medley of three songs. We may feature a little Name That Tune, so we might not tell the audience what it is that we're playing and ask them to tell us what we played. Hopefully they'll be able to recognize it, and that'll be good for us.
Yeah.
Satin Doll, that was an old Mills Brother hit, and we're going to be doing a version of that with a vocalist. So not only do we have a full band, 15-piece band, we have a vocalist, we will have various featured soloists within the band, and so it should be quite an evening.
Now, are you playing these songs without having to pay for them?
First of all, the concert itself is free,
okay? Yes.
But the acquisition of the music, interesting way this came about, my daughter's father-in-law had a big band up in the Boston area, and as he got older, as we all do, he kind of stopped with the band, and he had all this music, a big repository of music, and offered it up to us. So we were able to acquire quite a collection. We have about 150 pieces.
Wow, that's quite a deal.
And the fact that we're a nonprofit, there's no issue of the rights of the music. If we were, you know, so it's all come across very well for us.
Good, very good. Now, you talked about your mission, right, which was to play this old style type music. Is that basically
your
mission?
Yeah, you're right on, Paul. I think, you know, the mission started off was one of, as having the musicians play this music that they love.
Okay.
We've kind of expanded it to not only to play it from the point of view of practicing, but also to play it from the point of view of exposing people who still like to listen to it. So the mission is expanded, and furthermore, because there's so limited opportunity for this kind of music here, people that are musicians, whether high school kids, college kids, seniors, retired, still working, we still encourage them to participate in our practices. And even if they can't make the performances, it gives them an opportunity to play this kind of music.
Well, that's a great idea. So, and this is going to be on the 21st. And what time does it start? 7:30?
It starts at 7 o'clock.
7 o'clock.
7 o'clock. And like I said, run for about an hour and a half. And we're hoping we're going to put enough room in the front of the auditorium. If people get the urge to get up and move around, that they'll have an opportunity to do that. And we're hoping that will be the case. One of the things I should also
you're going to arrange it so that the place is set up so the middle is vacant.
Yeah, we'll have some space up in front of the bandstand where if people want to get up, there'll be room to do that. So that we encourage it. Just be careful, you know, in terms of we don't want any accidents happening for sure. One other thing I wanted to mention that's kind of another interesting point is that the band, like I said, is made up primarily of town band players from the various local locations. A swing band, by nature of the constitution, really requires other types of musicians that you don't normally find in a town band.
Really?
For instance, you know, a keyboardist or a pianist, you don't find those in the town bands because the town band music, the concert band music, doesn't usually have that in it. Bass players, whether it's a stand-up bass or a bass guitar, you don't find those in town bands. A jazz-type drummer with a full drum set, normally you don't see those in concert bands. So we were fortunate enough by our networking to go out there and find people that don't play. There's a few of us that don't play with the town bands that have the interest in the music and join us. So it's pretty much of a potpourri of musicians.
But you get everything in.
Yeah, well, that was the intent because each piece is key, so you really need to have the full instrumentation. Otherwise, you hear a gap in the music, especially when you listen to the music Glenn Miller. I mean, how many times have you heard Moonlight Serenade? You know exactly what it's going to sound like, and if you don't have the right instrumentation, it sounds like almost Moonlight Serenade. You know,
Well, it's good to have all that.
Oh, I tell you, and we've been having a ball. Like I said, we started last January. We went right through the winter. Snowstorms be damned, although we might have missed one or two along the way. But the people are committed to it. We usually get anywhere from, maybe 9 or 10 at a practice to as many as 15 and sometimes up to 20. So,
that's a big practice.
And we're encouraging people, again, if you're interested in the music, we've had walk-ons that see the notice out in the center hall of the community center. They show up on a Wednesday night with their instrument. They join us. They either like it and stay on or they move on, you know. So it's a great opportunity. So I think in addition to the concert, if you're, you know, we're a musician, like to be a musician, again, love this kind of music, either come and listen to it or come and actually participate with us in the band. We'd love to have you come down. Absolutely.
Oh, there you go. You got an invitation to the practice as well as the band.
Yeah, again, one last time. Let's make sure we get the message
right
here. It's October 21st. It's right here at the community center in the multipurpose room. Starts at 7 o'clock. And I want to thank Carolyn Carey and the rest of the people on staff here at the community center because they've been terrific in helping us to promote this, to accommodate us for the practice, and it's really appreciated. And it's clear that the people that work here certainly enjoy this kind of music, and I hope you folks out there in the audience world will come and enjoy it as well.
Just remember now, it's the 21st. That's a win. Is that a Wednesday?
It's a Wednesday night.
It's a Wednesday night.
That's correct, and it's free.
It's a Wednesday night. It's a free concert here at the community center, and it's going to have the big bands. And so Jim is going to be one of the players, and he's hoping that you all come
Absolutely. And
support the band. So thanks for being with us, Jim, and best of luck.
Thank you very much, Paul. Take care.